Again, except for the opening kickoff, there's no live television today, so game may proceed at a bit better pace. Big start, big changes are going to start on time.
Have we given the names of those departing?
How'd you do that, Herb?
Jeff Allen is one of those. Brian Donahue. Andrew Croker from Fayetteville, Arkansas. Kevin Miller, the runner and place kicker. Outside linebacker Donnie Spragan and Jeff Wilson.
They also acknowledged Patrick Shinnefield as a kicker and Brian Toner, a linebacker. Neither of them has played an awful lot, but both are, as I mentioned, they are seniors academically, and they were also introduced along with offensive lineman Matt Motherway from Modern Day High in Santa Ana. So that completes the nine that were actually introduced before the game today.
Stanford won the toss, Ted, and unlike earlier in the year,
Troy Walters will not start, but as Tyrone said, he will play a little bit. It's going to be limited. Dave Davis will not play at all. So the wide receiver first bit in. First down of the 23.
Miller, it's a low line drive, and into the 25, take a Stanford basketball pass.
51-yard punt,
and the Cougars get back up and start on their first possession at their own 5-yard line.
Saw John Sandy's dad prior to the game today, and of course he was a Rose Bowl hero back in 1970.
Academic all
the of
Ohio State, who won the Allen Trophy that year in the Rose Bowl. It will be long.
Offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, repeat first down.
Has had some tough times this year because often they've been placed in bad position, bad field position. A lot of times they kick returns, et cetera, but that squad bad. Here's where they came out with a 5-yard line. And they're not in the other numbers.
Touchdown
pass from Paul Wink to Ryan Taylor. are streaking down the near sideline. Timeout on the field, 7-0 Washington State on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Next up from Pepsi, MC Light.
Stanford Athletics would like to welcome all local Bay Area Regents students.
Now the big play and a defensive breakdown haunting Stanford once again.
41-82.
All right, Stevie. Dry day today, so we can hear Stevie. Miller punt. running Lamont Thompson. There's the single safety.
First down.
That was a very subtle
38-yard punt by Kevin Miller. First and 10 for the Cougars at their own 27.
In fact, he never made a visible fair catch. Now, he may have screamed fair catch, but he never made a visible fair catch signal. We see a replay. The players did play one. Bring him down for a loss. The receiver on the play, Farwan Subedi, a wide receiver playing, hasn't played much for the Cougars this year.
Right tackle jump.
Across the yard of the play.
They didn't call it that.
The play loses a yard. I think Stanford's happy with that. Second down, 11. Five wideouts now. Mickey under center.
Tim Smith, and Smith had to pick an angle of pursuit.
Ryan Lindell took the extra point.
Just a little bit short, and that receiver ran right by him, Billy Newman.
So here's the extra point. Time out on the field. It is Washington State 14, Stanford nothing on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Everybody loves something for free, so check out the new E-Trade. The number one rated online broker is now open free to the public. Track stocks, manage your portfolio, get real-time quotes all for free. Stock trades still from just $14.95. Call 1-800-E-TRADE-1 or go to www.etrade.com. E-Trade. Someday, we'll all invest this way.
OTC limit and orders over 5,000 shares cost more. At $15 for broker-assisted trades. Rated number one by Gomez Advisors' third quarter report on internet brokers. Member NASD SIPC.
I'm here talking with John Atkins about his wireless phone. John, what's with the tape on the mouth?
I'm afraid I'm talking the wireless phone too much.
You're afraid you'll talk on the wireless phone too much. Ever heard of GTE prepaid wireless? They let you buy the airtime you want so you can control your spending. And only GTE gives you a whisper alert. It tells you how many minutes you have left before every call. Call 1-800-800-4-GTE or visit any GTE wireless location.
GTE prepaid wireless. Know what you're spending and when you've spent it. Equipment not included. Enhanced services and roaming not available. Activation fee required. Other restrictions may apply.
Well, a quick start. Washington State up 14-0. Let's go down to Steve Frost.
Okay, guys, down on the field here. I don't know if you caught it from up in the booth, but the three wide receivers set to the left side on that touchdown and dangerously close to running a pick play on that. The inside receiver, the coaches down here weren't overly happy about that. They thought maybe there might have been a pick on that for one of those outside receivers. Hit our guy.
Lindell to kick off. Gales and Pitts deep for the Cardinals.
Arizona State, that five wide receiver set. Weren't happy to them, but again, Tyrone was concerned about it. You wind up there with Sherman.
Right. Right.
Right.
Right.
Penalty 10 yards from the previous spot, automatic first down.
That's a ball you might think is going to be caught.
Penalty on the Cougar, moving the ball to the 35-yard line, first and 10 to the
ball. I think that one to go to the other side. He made a very quick adjustment. That's a beautiful throw.
And Stanford at their own 40.
Thank you.
offense there at the start of the play, so a cool whistle jet. Some motion there by the Cardinals didn't work right, so we'll get backed up here at the 11-yard line.
No play, dead ball, false start, offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
The penalty on the Cardinals will go back to the 11-yard line. First and goal. Gain of a yard on the play.
Troy Walters is in the game at this point. Jeff Allen comes in.
Second and goal from the 10.
Russo comes back in. That indicates that this play will be a pass. Every indication is
four wide receivers.
Single coverage on Walters.
Personal service is no accident. So we can get you back on the road faster than you can say,
like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
At Lucent Technologies, we know it takes team spirit and dedication to stay ahead of the competition. And it's that attitude that has made our team a leader in communications technology. Lucent Technologies is proud to be Stanford University's telecommunications partner. Nothing beats the feeling of excitement when people work together, and working with you is what keeps us way out in front. Our goal is to provide business with reliable, quality communications equipment and voice messaging systems. For information about Lucent Technologies, call us at 1-800-247-7000.
Well, first quarter here, very finished.
Attempt the extra point.
can't miss the next Hollywood Squares with the superstars of comic relief, Robin Williams, Billy Crystal, and Whoopi Goldberg.
Will you shut up up there?
They're out of control. Don't miss it.
Hollywood Squares, weeknights at 7.
Kevin Sorbo kicked off.
Start offense. 5-yard penalty.
Mike Price not happy to make us keep yelling. Hey, don't let Breon Johnson be the ref here.
That time one posted up to the left side, and then Walters back there all by himself, and that is why he called for the fair catch.
And that's a big time punt. That's a 49 yard punt that forces a fair catch.
Little breeze at his back, as we said earlier.
All right, here comes Stanford to the line. USAC as Pitts and Uso left, Walters right, Allen the setback. 21 yard line for Stanford. Three step drop, pass to the far side to Troy, wrapped up right away. Gain of 5 to the 26. And that catch by Walters moves him further up the career passing list. Now he has gone by
gain of 4.
Justin Armour is 4th in the all-time career receiving list.
Nice throw by Todd. As long as those corners are going to play that song, no reason not to keep throwing out there.
Getting a lot of play. Yard gain on the play. 3rd and 5 from Number 14, Kevin Miller to play. Eight for the Cougars, number 19, Lamont Thompson.
That many owners are becoming a little too emotionally attached to their Tacomas. Considering the Tacoma's rugged good looks, famous dependability, and improved off-road package, this is understandable. This truck won't let you down when it comes to hard work and is always there for you when you want to have fun. So, no one's going to blame you for developing a strong bond with your Tacoma. However, certain obsessive behavior patterns are best kept in check. For instance, giving your Tacoma a name is acceptable, but talking to it in public is inadvisable, and singing to it is certainly to be avoided. Keeping your Tacoma's picture in your wallet and taking long moonlit drives to get to know it better is a little strange. Sleeping in the garage to be close to it is downright weird. For more details on how to develop a happy, yet healthy relationship with a new Tacoma, see your Northern California Toyota dealer today.
Challenged a couple of guys individually. from the 45.
Washington State trainers are looking at his left leg. Remember, he had a bad knee injury in January, a torn ACL, and had major surgery. It's amazing he's playing football so quickly after that.
And these two quarterbacks, just like the two at Arizona, they're used to trading places with one another.
All right, while they look at Birnbaum, we'll take a timeout. 14-7 Washington State on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Oh, Frank, this summer is going to be fun.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Now that I'm working for Budweiser, I've rented out a summer branch.
Summer branch?
Yeah,
really?
It's a low-slung branch right over the water.
Those branches are expensive. You should save your money.
Oh, not this summer.
No?
Now I'm going to stock the fridge with Budweiser and buy a 2-month supply of hot dogs.
Yeah, that's a smart investment, hot dogs.
We'll invite the Iguana Girls over. Mm. Turn up the radio.
What was that?
Boom, boom, boom,
what was that?
Boom, boom, boom.
Hey, you.
Club Louie. Boom, 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 boom.
Going
to be fun.
Hey,
boom,
hey, boom, Club Louie, what about a fly fishing trip?
Frankie, I'm a celebrity now.
Yeah.
I need to lead a more flamboyant lifestyle.
A flamboyant lifestyle?
Nocturnal living. Late nights, cold bud.
Chicky, boom, what's happening?
Frankie, I'm sorry. I got you.
All right,
I'm still saying this. I would like you to start calling me Moose.
I'm not gonna call you Moose.
The reptile.
Anderson's punt rolls out of bounds at the park of 25.
And the Cougars on their fourth down play punting.
30-yard punt by Anderson. First and 10 for the Cardinals. They're on 25.
From 75 yards out, and the last two times they've had to punt. So Stanford defense at least has risen up to that extent, and Stanford has the ball, and anytime they have the ball down by seven, they got a chance to tie it up. They've got the ball on the 25, and let's see if Troy Walters is in there now. No, he's not.
Stanford had trouble getting
Take him? Who came off?
I got the last back to go outside. Generation X is bound to outlast. Can you feel it? Yeah. How it's going down. Next time it's now. Come together, gather round.
Generation X.
Thank you.
Sometimes that blitz runs right into a running play, and that's what happened that time.
And that was a live football that Allen dropped, but the officials just evened things up with the ball Stanford stripped from the receiver a little bit ago.
Not the first down play that they were planning.
Second and 14.
Lamont Thompson to get out of the game.
Difficult for him going to the wide side.
sort of looking a little bit like last week. They're sputtering, and they've had five possessions, four punts from their own territory.
That's right. The only difference right between two punts on the top, two punts on the bottom, and in the middle, that drive of 65 yards in nine plays for the touchdown that has made it.
It's a 47-yard punt.
Third down.
And the worst thing about that play is that Real Johnson is down there on his side. And they're
Nia Taylor had the catch. Carter knocked it out of his hands. Real Johnson now does get up. Cobbler off the ankle. He's injured.
45-yard line.
So now the Cougars get another shot. It's third and seven.
Third and seven.
At their own. Shot it convert on a pass from Benke to Rockmore at the 40th Stanford.
Stanford comes in with their base defense now. Sharkus Steen, linebacker, comes in.
So the Cougars are 9:20 to go.
Jason White, incomplete.
The impression is going like
fingertips into the football. He was hit by Thompson. Nice defensive play.
Well, Thompson's the kind of defensive back Stanford needs. Big, strong, athletic safety man. He's got a great nose.
37.
6'2", 14. 10 turns.
Trying to get the first down. They've had
37 at 30 yards. Football Radio Network.
You know, some things are just so great, they're worth waiting for. In fact, waiting seems to make some things even better. Like when you smell cookies baking in the oven. Or when you hear holiday music while you're shopping for presents. Or when you feel a baby kick before it's born. Waiting in line at the bank probably wouldn't make that list. Because to us, being fast isn't just a matter of speed. It's a matter of respect. Wells Fargo. Fast then, fast now. Member FDIC.
Well, Murph, the Cardinal finding out that other teams have had their problems this year, too. 12-man penalty.
11-yard touchdown pass from Todd Huzan.
Kept that drive alive, and the Cardinal wind up putting it in the end zone.
We always try to note the end of the play or play touchdown. Asani carried it in from a yard. It was Pitts, you remember, on the 20-yard gainer, and Allen with that wonderful 19-yard run. Just as you suggest, yeah. My note here is 12 men on the field. That was the big play of the drive. Stanford got a renewed life. A lot of the time, it's like 14-7. Nebraska over Kansas State. Now they just put up 14-7.
First touchdown drive, Stanford really
had a good
stage. Weak side. Came back last time, Washington base shifted over to the weak side.
Second inning number 22.
Neely.
To take on a new career, we have great news. Applied Signal Technology is now seeking qualified individuals to join their team. Applied Signal Technology is recognized as a leader in the telecommunications field and is committed to excellence in engineering. At Applied Signal Technology, engineers are exposed to a wide variety of telecommunications concepts and disciplines. If this sounds like the direction you'd like to pursue as an engineer, visit Applied Signal Technology on the web at www.appsig.com for more information. Take advantage of this opportunity to work with the best. At Applied Signal Technology, technology isn't just their last name, it's their advantage. To learn more, visit
2:32 to play in the half. The Cougars are up 21-14 on touchdown plays of 62 and 75 yards through the air and 55 yards on the ground.
Yeah, that's a lot of time for the Cougars, 2:32. What did it take them last time? Less than a minute?
7 seconds. Well, I hate to belabor the point, but it's the story. The Cougars, the last time they had the ball, went 89 yards in two plays. There's a handoff to Brown off the right side. He's out to the 25 before being dragged down from behind by Marcus Hoover. The Cougars at third down and third and about 19 on their last possession after spraying and sacking the quarterback. To go in the half. That today's Stanford game is being sponsored in part by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you that fresh beer tastes better for that crisp, clean taste you'll find in no other beer. This Bud's for you. By your Northern California Toyota dealers, who invite fans to come in and test drive a Toyota today. By State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By your Northern California Pepsi Cola bottler, the choice of Stanford University and Generation Next. And by Wells Fargo Bank. At the Rose Bowl, UCLA has to host USC, which will have a two-week period to prepare. And the Bruins still have to go play Miami at the Orange Bowl. Makeup game December the 5th.
Of course, SC has Notre Dame lurking behind that UCLA game.
Catch all the action this basketball season.
SC can play defense. And Miami shall give UCLA.
All right, now third down.
Go to this side.
Third and 10 for the 46.
Walters with single coverage.
I'll tell you, this has been a first half for Stanford of a lot of near misses in offensive passing.
Left a second on the clock, Ted, and the Cougars, you know, would like to have had a second or perhaps two left on the clock in the Rose Bowl.
Third and eight.
One more chance to beat Michigan.
That's when they should have had instant replay. That was horrible.
That's what Mike Price said. He got a Rose Bowl watch, but it was 2 seconds off.
Hey, here's Matt.
Wise. Oh, I like that. That's nice. Hey,
Louis.
Wise. Oh, I'm in the zone.
Louis,
I'm sexy.
Louis, what are you doing?
I'm practicing.
Louis, just say the line.
Oh, Francis, babe.
Yeah?
Just say the line.
Yeah.
That's why you're still sitting on the branch. I'm performing on the swamp.
Get over yourself. Oh, man.
If Budweiser wanted someone to just say the line, as you naively put it,
yes,
they'd have hired a chimpanzee and saved themselves a little money.
Yeah, the chimp is probably booked on a bigger job.
Right? Oh, ha-ha.
Yeah, you've lost touch with reality, you know that?
Frankie, when I say wise, do you know what that does? Do you have any idea what that does?
Yeah, it makes me sick to my stomach.
Yeah, well, get a grip.
Okay.
It sells beer.
Oh,
okay?
Really?
It moves the Budweiser off the shelf.
Mm.
Zoom.
Yeah.
Zoom.
Uh-huh.
It's like Louis Mania.
Oh, really?
Louis El Nino.
Oh, I'm sure. I just can't keep
this
in stock.
But I have a little quiet here.
Bud.
Wise.
Oh, yeah. That's going to sell some beer.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Halftime at Stanford Stadium. Washington State 21, Stanford 14. First half of big plays. Three long touchdown plays by Washington State. The third one, a 55-yard run by Kevin Brown in the second quarter that broke a 14-all tie. And Murph, everything in football is interrelated. And I got the sense Stanford weathered those blows, those two big touchdown passes in the first quarter, came back, grew even, and then the defense just broke down completely and gave up two humongous plays. Washington State scores to regain the lead, and I think you just sense the effect that has on the football team, because suddenly the offense is trying to do too much, knowing they're going to have to score 50 points to win a football game and try to offset the demoralizing effect of the big play.
21-14, Cougars on top of the Cardinals. Stanford Vandae, as we said a moment ago.
My God, what is that? I walked outside to go to the bathroom. I come back in, and what is this?
Thank you for sharing that with us.
It looks like Janet Reno's dance party on the field.
Don't get us. Get yourself in trouble. Don't take me with you, okay? Hey, interesting stuff going on here. Michigan on top of Wisconsin today, 27-10. Penn State, 41-10 over Northwestern. And Northwestern scored first in that game. 33-14, Florida over South Carolina. And Texas A&M beat Missouri today, 17-14. There's some other good ones. Purdue upended Michigan State right on the heels of the Spartans beating the Buckeyes last week, 25-24 Boilermakers in that one. And Indiana by 1 point over Minnesota, 20-19, Ted.
Yep, other ones up. Of course, California will play Arizona, 3:30 game in Berkeley. Big game for the Golden Bears, who are hoping to qualify for a bowl. Oregon pounding Arizona State after one quarter up in Eugene, 24-7. I think we saw that happen. Oregon over Arizona State down at Spartan Stadium. San Jose State trailing 7-0 after one quarter against San Diego State. Of course, the other big ones, the real big ones, late second quarter in Manhattan, Kansas, 17-7 Nebraska over Kansas State. And Murph, this is the day that, this is the single day of legitimacy for Kansas State. If they win today, they're a legitimate contender for the national championship. Basically, they would have only a Big 12 championship game and then the bowl game to play.
Yeah, with what Bill Snyder's done back there, I'd hate to call him illegitimate, but they have done a remarkable job at Kansas State. When you talk about going, what's the old proverb there, from the outhouse to the penthouse, and they nearly have done it.
I mean, he's done it the way, and quite frankly, the way you have to do it at a place like that, the way Mike Price done it at Washington State. You know, you're going out, you're recruiting junior colleges, you're taking a lot of kids that are questionable qualifiers at the outset, kids that academically may not be suited for some of the better institutions.
but are good football players. And that's what Bill Snyder has done, because Manhattan, Kansas has not been a place where you can go out and recruit the cream of the crop, so to speak.
Remember my old pal Vince Gibson used to coach at Kansas State, and I said, Vince, mm-hmm. I said, I've heard rumors. I said, you don't cheat, do you? And he says, man, he says, you don't think anybody's happening by Manhattan, Kansas on purpose, do you?
Good.
Always remember that.
Well, Arkansas leads Tennessee 14-0 in the second quarter. And the UCLA's up 13-10 over Washington second quarter. Notre Dame 14-0 over Navy in the second quarter. And Air Force leads Wyoming 10-3 in the fourth quarter. If Air Force wins that game, I think that'll put them in the WAC championship game.
Nice now, the WAC. What is the WAC? Who is the WAC? And well, where is the WAC?
For today, Murph.
Well, I'll tell you what happened. It's kind of interesting what happened. You know, the student section really filled in after the game got started. I think they must have closed the library at 12:30 or something. Something happened.
Either that or the Dutch Goose.
As was the case a week ago, it's pretty spotty over there as a lot of students have left in that game. They have this big beer garden across the street in Norman, Oklahoma, and they all leave at halftime, and only half of them maybe come back. And the ones that come back are in very good shape.
Austin Lee out there, so Cardinal having to go a little deeper into the defensive front as they have now rolled Hoover over on his back at the 28-yard line to look at him. The first half numbers, again, we mentioned 328 yards for Washington State, 194 for Stanford. Cusack was 12 of 28, 142 yards, one touchdown, and I think there'll be a lot of folks wondering if the Cardinal would consider making a change at that position. Todd, who did not play well last week, had a very difficult, particularly near the end of the first half. Brian Allen carried 16 times for 59 yards. Good running game for Allen in the first half. But Kevin Brown of the Cougars had 15 carries for 123 yards.
Boy, that has been just a continuing problem for the Stanford defense. They've had other problems too, but the good running back, the guy that can really move, they have not been able to stop. And you think of all of the, I was going to say candidates, he's one of them.
Yep.
Drones, of course, at Oregon, went for over 200 yards. And there have been some outstanding runners that Stanford has not been able to stop. And you got to put Kevin Brown in that category. Of course, that long run, the touchdown run of 55 yards, that helped him considerably.
Well, Brown is now almost 900 yards for the year. So will the game be played at six games of 100 yards already. Hoover now being helped off the field. He's clearly groggy after his hit. Cougar started. Oh.
Boston receiver, number 89, Jerry Bockler. Pushed out of bounds by number 90, Mark Stoppler. Gain of 12 on the play.
Reuben Carter had real trouble here. He was not able to cover. Then he was not able to stop the receiver, and he picks up another 4 or 5 yards for the first down. So if you can't break up the pass, you certainly have to be able to stop. And that's been a continuing problem for this team.
And a round on the ball carrier. Sharpness.
Right now, Reuben Carter's getting a major lesson now because the Cougars are picking the poor kid apart. And they're throwing almost every ball.
2 yards.
Reuben is hitting the game.
Update on Marcus Hoover. Originally we thought maybe it was with his head. It's actually looks like a neck injury. They were testing his mobility a little bit. Doesn't look like anything career threatening, but unsure right now whether Marcus is going to be able to return to the game.
And of course that's Stanford saw that very vividly with Maxwell Stevenson, who has not played since he was taken off the field.
Back into
it was a 37-yard punt by Miller.
Not a good punt by Miller.
And a good run.
run back by Lamar Thompson. Washington State will start at the Stanford 47.
Well, Stanford had their chance, Ted. Not that it's all over by any means, but the defense held, and then they couldn't do anything with the ball offensively, and then it's compounded by the fact that Washington State starts in Stanford territory.
Four wide receivers now for third down.
Everywhere to keep it loose and tight. now their goal to provide business with reliable quality communications equipment and voice messaging system. Lucent Technologies in support of Blitz Mobile's 1-800-247-7000. Bobby Pitts for the 32 of the Cardinal first down.
No imitation, no limitation. It's the next generation.
another punt. And Stanford's not had the offensive success that they would have expected.
Kevin will watch that, not coming back as carefully as he can.
for the Cougars from the two.
And that one does the job, hitting the Cougars deep. Timeout, 21-14, Washington State on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
At Lucent Technologies, we know it takes team spirit and dedication to stay ahead of the competition. And it's that attitude that has made our team a leader in communications technology. Lucent Technologies is proud to be Stanford University's telecommunications partner.
Packaging means tickets and tickets to Hoop City. Plus, selected packages provide access to private parties during the week. For more information, the hotline, 725-9099.
For information about Lucent Technologies, call us at 1-800-247-7000.
Pepsi is the official soft drink of Stanford Athletics. Nothing else is Pepsi.
Gilmore, a junior,
Jr. was the backup halfback for the Cougars. And the ball to 47 for the second down and 7. Minute and 28 to go.
3 yards on that carry.
It was 21-42.
Second and 7.
Already got from the 47. Sam Smith's interception, but not opportunistic.
To that ball so suddenly.
Boy, what a great, huge play by Tim Smith. His second interception of the third quarter saves Stanford again for the time being, and the third quarter comes to an end. It'll be Stanford football at the 4-yard line when we come back. 21-14 Washington State on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Oh, yeah. Nothing like a few days in L.A. to take your mind off work. Oh, Garcon, another Shirley Temple play. Oh, my gosh, Alex Trebek.
That's absolutely right. And you are?
Me? Oh, I'm the spokes guy for Alaska Airlines.
Oh, Alaska. Hey, great airline.
Yeah.
You know, I sometimes fly them to Vancouver. I'm Canadian, eh?
Really? So you must know that Alaska gives you more for the same low fares as the discount airlines.
I'm sorry, no. Things like more flights throughout the West and frequent flyer miles that never expire don't come cheap.
But, Mr. Trebek, on Alaska, for the same price, you just get more.
Wow, Stanford has gone now. John, okay. Back to the right.
straight ahead and ran it all the way back to the 31-yard line.
And a 19-yard punt return.
So a 47-yard punt, but a 19-yard return. And so
at the Cardinal 31.
That one, the net isn't as good as what you would have hoped for Stanford. The Cardinal have had difficulties all year covering kicks. 21-14. 21-14. Timeout, 28-14, Washington State on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
The flagship station of the Oakland Raiders.
KTCT, San Mateo, Oakland, San Francisco.
Touchdown Raiders!
This is the new ticket, 1050.
Oh, Frank.
Hey, Louis.
This summer's going to be fun.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Now that I'm working for Budweiser, I've rented out a summer branch.
Summer branch?
Yeah,
really?
It's a low-slung branch right over the water.
Those branches are expensive. You should save your money.
Oh, not this summer.
No?
I'm going to stock the fridge with Budweiser and buy a 2-month supply of hot dogs.
Yeah, that's a smart investment. Hot dogs.
We'll invite the Iguana Girls over. Mm. Turn up the radio.
Right. What was that?
Boom, boom, boom.
What was that?
Boom, boom.
In the third quarter, third round, UCLA 20, Washington 10. Also a third quarter score, 12th ranked Notre Dame 14, Navy nothing.
I would like you to study.
1 minute left in the second quarter. It is 20th ranked Oregon 31, LSU State 13.
Michael in the room, 36. That was a 31-yard kickoff return.
Thank you.
21 on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Okay, so I haven't always made the brightest purchases, like that home karaoke system and the pine-scented car seat covers. But I do want to tell you about the purchase that totally makes up for those others. It's the one I'm honestly proud of because I can always rely on it. And no, it's not the precision home haircutting flimby thing. My smart purchase is actually the Toyota Camry. Not only does the Camry have all the UBBA words like reliable, dependable, and affordable, but the word more describes all of them. Which completely explains why the Camry is the number one selling car in America and why I decided on the Camry. Now, I know what you may be thinking, but no, the dealer didn't promise to throw in a bonus carving set. It's just that the Camry has everything my family and I needed, and honestly, that's all it took. So visit your Northern California Toyota dealer today and see for yourself why the Toyota Camry really is the smart choice, even for someone who occasionally has a...
Thank you.
The controls. Borchardt has played the entire second half. Todd Husak did not have a very effective first half, especially the second quarter. So the Cardinal made a quarterback change at halftime. Earliest they've done that in the game this year. Now Borchardt has an eye set behind him. Not a good one. That's only a 29-yard punt. And the Cougars will take over at the Stanford 44-yard line.
He has actually punted half that number. He's punted 10 times
That's
today.
10. Wow.
In this second half, he punted four times in a row, followed by Ide's touchdown, and then another punt. So Stanford has punted four out of five possessions.
Now Menke hands off to Brown. Willie Howard there. Nice stop by Willie. Got him at the line of scrimmage. In fact, stripped the ball again, but the play will be blown dead. Stockbauer helping. Under 9 minutes to play. 28-21. Washington State the lead.
Thank you.
tackled by number 13, Tank Williams.
The 7:39 to play, down 28-21.
Well, this is probably a deciding possession in this game, Ted. And once again, not trying to be too dramatic, but 7:39 on the clock, down by seven. Probably comes down to this one.
Byron Plasby.
Sorry.
Tampa Bay in the early years. Somebody asked him what he thought about the execution of his defense. The Giants might be in favor. Only John McKay can get away with that.
He had away with words.
Offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Beautiful Lake Tahoe. This is just one of the many great drives that start with Dollar Rent-A-Car. For more information on the most scenic drives in the world, call them at 1-800-800-4000 or visit their website at www.dollar.com. Dollar features quality products of the Chrysler Corporation and other fine cars at SFO, Oakland, and San Jose airports, as well as the downtown San Francisco location. Great drives start with Dollar Rent-A-Car because Dollar makes sense.
So I bet you hit the snooze button one too many times this morning, huh? And let me guess, the tile on the bathroom floor? Ooh, just a wee bit chilly. And your bed? Darn thing still hasn't